What we do is we make a matrix and also a vector. And we label the matrix, which is quadratic, with all the poses and all the landmarks. And here we assume the landmarks are distinguishable. And every time we make an observation, say between two poses, they become little additions locally in the four elements in the matrix defined over those poses. So for example, if the robot moves from x0 to x1, and we therefore believe x1 should be the same as x0, say plus 5. The way we enter this into the matrix is in two ways. First, 1 x0 minus 1 x1s added together should be, well, minus 5. So we look in the equation here, x0 minus x1 equals minus 5. These are added into the matrix that starts with 0 everywhere, and it's a constraint that relates x0 and x1 by minus 5. It's that simple. Secondly, we do the same with x1 as positive, so we add 1 over here. And for that, x1 minus x0 equals plus 5. So you put 5 over here and a minus 1 over here. Put differently, the motion constraint that relates x0 to x1 by the motion of 5 has modified incrementally by adding values the matrix for all elements that fall between x0 and x1. We basically wrote that constraint twice. In both cases, we made sure the diagonal element was positive, and then we wrote the correspondence off-diagonal element as a negative value, and we added the corresponding value on the right side. So let me ask you a question. Suppose we know we go from x1 to x2, and whereas the motion over here was plus 5, say now it's minus 4. So we're moving back in the opposite direction. What would be the new values for the matrix over here? And I give you a hint, they only affect values that occur in the region between x1 and x2 and over here. And remember, these are additive.